Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a Kia vehicle, practically any Kia vehicle. If you want to know guys what are the symptoms of bad tie rod or signs of bad outer tie rod status, we will explain that on a Kia vehicle. Even though we will be demonstrating on a Kia Optima, the video should be helpful on the following Kia models. Okay, it should help on Kia Forte, Kia Optima, Sportage, Sorento, Soul, and Kia Rio as well. Let's go ahead and explain what to expect if you have a bad tie rod. Also, what you always need to do, okay, if you replace that tie rod. So make sure you stay until the end, and we're going to cover and talk about that as we go. So let us guys tell us a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. We try to take them completely apart and show you how to fix pretty much anything. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return guys, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Something else, if you need to buy parts, tools for your Kia vehicle, we'll share the links in the description of the video below where we get all our tools and parts from. Check it out, parts for really good price and quick shipping as well. In addition guys, if you want to save even more money and learn how to fix your car for free, check out our main channel Auto Repair guys. You can find so much helpful information that can save you thousands of dollars on future car repairs guys. We have helped more than 100 million people on this channel. So let's start on it now. So we have the tie rod removed out of this Kia vehicle guys, okay, and we want to show you okay what we have specifically here. This tie rod will be, that's the outer tie rod, it's connected usually to the inner tie rod, and then it connects to the steering knuckle right here. When you turn your steering wheel, it activates the power steering, then that will move the rack and pinion. From there, the rack and pinion will move the inner tie rod, which is connected to the outer tie rod, and your wheel will steer left or right. Now that tie rod, most of the times guys, what will happen, okay, the ball joint will develop a play. Sometimes you may have a play, even if the seal looks fine, you don't need grease, it's not cracked, you may develop a play if it's really old sometimes, failing ball joint. In other cases, most of the times what will happen, that seal will break, water and dust will get inside, that will eat the ball joint and it will develop a play. When you develop a play, that's when we talk about symptoms and signs of bad outer tie rod. When you have that play guys, what you can expect? Number one thing, tire wear, uneven tire wear, accelerated tire wear, because your alignment will be off. You will have, okay, your wheel will be able to move a little bit depending how much play you have in the ball joint. As a result guys, okay, that will cause the alignment to be off and your tires will wear fast and unevenly as well. Number two guys, you will feel vibrations in the steering wheel when you drive down the road. Number three, you may feel like you're kind of like fighting to keep your vehicle on the road. Why? Because that tire that has play, okay, in the ball joint, will kind of like follow road imperfections, it will wander off, and your car will be kind of like floating, will always fighting the steering wheel to keep it on the road, which is very, very dangerous because makes your vehicle unpredictable and unstable as well. Another thing, you may hear noises, clunking, squealing, okay, all kind of noises coming from that ball joint if it's bad. Especially if the seal is broken, there is no grease in the ball joint, you can hear all kind of noises coming from the suspension as well. So always check for that one too. Another thing, you can guys experience even the whole vehicle vibrating in some cases because of that bad ball joint. But it's very dangerous to drive with a bad ball joint because bad tie rod, because if it fails, that ball joint can come off. As a result, what will happen actually guys, it can come off all the way and you will lose the ability to steer your vehicle. So then you're in big trouble. And we recommend to always replace both outer tie rods at the same time and inspect your inner ones as well. Now, every time you replace those things, you need to take the vehicle for alignment because your alignment most likely will be off once you remove and install the new one. So always take it to a professional alignment center and have the vehicle aligned. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.